Assalamu alaikum everyone, and welcome to our new show, which is titled as Did You Know? Each week we will highlight a new sector and the work which USAID is doing under different sectors. So keep following us on Facebook and you will have all of the opportunity to join our participants through posing your questions right below on the Facebook page. In today's show, we are going to talk about the Small Medium Enterprises activity. And this is a very interesting topic. Today with us, we have three amazing ladies who are wonderful in their work.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Afshin Shakur and I'm working with USAID in Islamabad.
My name is Tabir and I'm working with USAID Small and Medium Enterprise Activity as Competitiveness Enhancement Specialist.
This is Nisa Fez from Peshawar. I am the founder of Khawateen Rozgar Services, which is a platform for female job seekers.
So Afshin, starting with you, can you please tell us briefly about Samia and the support it gives to the small and medium enterprises?
Thank you, Shaila. Thank you for this opportunity. And as you said, Small and Medium Enterprise Activity, we call it SMEA. It's a five-year program, and it is available all across Pakistan. It is a flagship SME program from USAID Mission Pakistan. And what it aims to do is to create an enabling environment for private sector businesses through policy advocacy. We also work towards the competitiveness enhancement of SMEs through the provision of business development support services. And the third component in the program is a challenge fund through which we provide grant equity to SMEs and entrepreneurs, by which I mean startups, to actually explore growth and innovative ventures through the grant challenge fund under Small and Medium Enterprise Activity.
Very interesting. So how does Samia actually has met the challenges posed by COVID-19?
So a very interesting question, Shaila. And you know that these small and medium enterprises that actually account for more than 3.4 million enterprises all across Pakistan, the biggest challenge during this COVID-19 crisis for these SMEs was to basically stay operational, retain their staff and their clients, and also to ensure that they have enough cash flows to run their businesses through the crisis. So under SMEA, what we did was, as our first, first advantage to these SMEs, we provided up to 100% support for business development support services, through which they can actually venture into e-commerce or digital platforms to make sure that they are operational during these crucial times. What we are also doing is that we are launching a grant very specific to COVID-19 challenge, and through the grant funds, SMEs can actually apply to stay and revive their businesses, sustain their growth, and during this COVID-19 crisis, and also after when the pandemic is inshallah over.
Okay, that's very interesting. So how can people find out about the grants which Samia is offering?
So, through the local newspapers, we advertise them regularly whenever the initiative is launched. We also post the initiatives on our Facebook page of USAID. If you want more detailed information, you can reach out to the project directly through the email address that will also be shown on the screen. And I'm going to spell it out for you as well. So smea_info@pakistansmea.com. And for more information about the activities, Tabir is going to speak more about those detailed activities.
We have multiple activities which are categorized into two interrelated interventions. The first are general or technical trainings, which are basically free of cost. We have recently transitioned online. Previously, we were carrying these out in person, but due to COVID and to facilitate interested entrepreneurs, we started conducting these trainings online. Some of the most popular and most in-demand trainings that we've had recently have consisted of business management and marketing, digital marketing, and even improving financial worthiness for women entrepreneurs. The second and more complex intervention pertains to hardcore business development services, which are on cost share basis. This is where SMEA and the SME both contribute to pay registered business development service providers to help businesses in availing support at subsidized rates. Again, some of the most popular services that we've had so far have consisted of digital marketing, which consists of brand building, search engine optimization, social media management. Then we've also had a lot of demand for ICT solutions, which can consist of software development or website design and administration. And then the third and final most popular service that we've had has consisted of quality and safety certifications. These activities are demand driven. Hence, the trainings, the service providers, as well as the services themselves are all basically extracted out of demand from the SME.
How do you monitor the progress?
Yeah. So for trainings, it's quite simple because the intervention is small and short term. We monitor progress by assessing whether the trained SMEs have inducted any new management practices. Perhaps previously they were targeting a different market and now we have helped them target a completely new market, or they've revised their pricing strategies. We also look at whether they've utilized any new technological innovations. Perhaps previously they were using traditional marketing strategies and now they're using online marketing techniques on Facebook, WhatsApp, or Instagram. However, for business development services, our progress monitoring is a lot more extensive. We take a periodic deeper dive into analyzing SME growth in terms of their increase in sales, jobs, exports, and even private sector investment. For a more practical idea of how this works, I'm going to let Misbah talk about it in a little more detail.
I'm sure you know our viewers would like to know more about the Khawateen Rozgar Services and how did you exactly started your business?
Okay, thank you so much, Sheila. So Khawateen Rozgar Services is a platform that connects the female human resource with the employers. So we have females who are metric qualified up to PhD qualified. They can be fresh or they can have up to 20 years of experience. They can be skilled or unskilled. So our platform provides opportunities to all the women across Pakistan. So how I started Khawateen Rozgar Services is that it was my vision to serve the females of my community and my country. And I really wanted to do something for them. So this is a step in order to empower the women of our country.
Why did you feel the need for an employment portal just for women?
I was on job since 4 years, and that is when I realized that, you know, females cannot go from offices to offices to drop their CVs. And it is even hard for the females to actually recognize that which email IDs and which job postings are legit on the internet. So they cannot just drop off their CV on every email ID they see across. So it was really necessary that females have a platform so that they are able to, you know, drop their CVs to those employers who are legitimate, and also so that they have the opportunity to apply for jobs with the ease of sitting from their home, just on one click.
Okay, that's wonderful. So what was the feedback from the woman when you started your business?
So the feedback was absolutely overwhelming. It was fantastic. We were not expecting such a quick and such a rapid response from the market. And the females, they were really happy that this platform had been started. And we received so many calls, so many messages, so many queries daily. As you know, females are eagerly looking for jobs that fit their requirements, their skill set, and their qualifications. So the main sectors include teaching, office assistant, receptions, sales jobs, administrative work, data entry work.
And how many applications you have received?
Currently, we have over 14,000 females that are registered with us in our database. Yeah. And they are mainly looking for jobs, you know, in all the fields I mentioned. Besides that, we have engineers, doctors, accountants, all registered with us.
Misbah, did all of the candidates find the job?
So currently we have more than 600 females that are that we have placed in different organizations, and we have placed in the fields of office assistant, receptionist, teachers, tutors, sales and marketing, paid volunteer works, internships, accountants, graphic designings. So I believe that the females have a lot of potential and they have a very strong will. All they need is a very strong support in order to support them further to achieve their ambitions and their dreams. So SMEA has helped me in scaling up. We are in the process of scaling up, and I believe SMEA has to play a very important and a very crucial role in it. And it is helping us in order to reach the masses. And also it is helping us to fight the current situation of COVID-19 through the IT platform, which we are developing with the help of SMEA. We have adapted around 60%, And we are still in the process to come up with such strategies so that we completely shift towards, online interviews as well. So we are also in the process of making one-to-one online interviews available for the candidates as well as the employers so that they don't have to physically be in contact.
And I'd like to add something here is that the biggest challenge for us was to basically adapt our assistance to respond to this COVID-19 crisis. And the biggest, support that we could provide to these SMEs was through digitalization or pushing the e-commerce platforms. And this came in really handy for us to ensure that the businesses are continuing their operation and they are able to retain the workforce, because unemployment has also surfaced as a very big challenge during the COVID-19 crisis.
Where can women find more information about your services?
Right. So they can visit our website, khawateen.org, or they can visit our Facebook page with the name of Khawateen, or they can simply call us on our official number, which is 0332-936-5589 for any kind of information that they need.
Oh, thank you so much, ladies. With this, we come to the end of our program. Thank you so much for joining with us. Keep following us on Facebook and feel free to post your questions just in the comments below. Thank you so much and Allah Hafiz.